Hey everyone, my name is Rahul, and today we're going to be going over part three of my three-part guide to breadth first search, or BFS. In the first two parts, we talked about what BFS is, we went over some examples, and also how to code it in Java. So if you missed those two parts, click right up here in the top right-hand corner. I have a card that'll link you to both of those videos. I recommend checking those out first, and then jumping right back here to part three. Today, we're going to be talking about some interview tips for BFS. If you end up liking this video, please consider sharing it with a friend and hit that like button. It's a free and easy way to support my channel. And consider subscribing for more content that's just like this. I'm excited to put out more content that'll help you land coding-related jobs through helping you through the coding interview process, as well as the fundamentals like data structures and algorithms. Without further ado, let's get straight into the interview tips for BFS. When it comes to interview tips, we're going to split this into two main buckets: when you should think about using BFS and when you probably shouldn't think about using BFS. We're going to first start about when you should think about using BFS. In that, there's two main scenarios. First is when you have to find a path from one node to another. That's the simple case that we've explained throughout a lot of our examples. If you need to find a path from one node to another, then BFS is an option for you. In this case, it can usually be used interchangeably with DFS or depth first search. Both of them will be able to find a path from one vertex to another in any graph-like data structure. The second case is when you want to find the shortest path in an unweighted graph. This is the big difference between DFS and BFS. Where DFS only finds you a path, BFS will find you the shortest path so long as the graph has unweighted edges. If the graph does have weighted edges, this will not give you the shortest path. In fact, we'll be covering that in a future video, but stay tuned for that. For now, we need to know that BFS is great when we want to find either a path or the shortest path between one node and another. As for when you shouldn't use BFS, there's only really one main case that I can think of, and that's when you want to find a node that is deep inside of your graph or tree, meaning that the distance between the starting node and the destination is very large. Because BFS starts off by visiting all nodes at a distance of 1 from the starting node, then of 2, and then of 3, and so on. Because of this, BFS is going to be very inefficient when it comes to finding nodes that are really far away from the starting node. But if the destination node is close, then maybe BFS is the right way to go. It's up to your judgment on that to decide on which one's going to be the most useful. Now that we know when we should and shouldn't use BFS, we also need to remember that it's important to understand all of the alternatives to BFS. Knowing the alternative algorithms like depth first search, Dijkstra's algorithm, and more are going to allow you to understand when is the best time to use BFS and should I be using another algorithm in its place. These are going to be topics that I will cover in future videos, so if you don't know them yet, don't worry, feel free to subscribe for that. But regardless, it's important for you to remember that there are many algorithms out there that may be able to do a similar operation, but might be able to do it more or less efficiently. So we want to understand all of the different algorithms for searching through a graph before we go ahead and choose one to use on an interview. Well, those were my interview tips for BFS on coding interviews, and my three-part guide on the breadth-first search algorithm. If you enjoyed these videos and this entire series, please leave a like down below and share it with a friend, and consider subscribing for more content like this. These are free and easy ways, again, to support my channel. I'm looking forward to putting out more content that's just like this to help you learn about the foundation of data structures and algorithms, plus to give you some coding interview tips. But until next time, see you. We'll be right back.